cell with your name on it by now. You had a good job of that, didn't you? When are you going to wise up, Adam? Make a legitimate living out of cars.
I don't know.
You fix them up as well as you smash them up, you make a fortune.
It's not so much fun, though, is it?
Now there's 18 months inside. Right, where'd you find this knife?
Oh, well, it was in the boot under the spare wheel, like I told him.
Go on then, show us.
What? Well, I popped the lock, yeah? And I got the spare wheel out of the way, and I was moving the carpet out of the way, and there was this carry bag underneath it. So I thought, you know, hello. Wonder what's in here. So I opened it up and...
That's when me and Rich came along.
Knife was inside the bag.
Well, you think it's been used for something, yeah? What, like to kill someone?
Dave, do you want to take Mr. Reynolds back to his cell?
Come on.
Oh, mate. How are you? What are you doing? Nothing? Could you have robbed the magistrate, couldn't you? You know, tell him about you find a murderer or something.
He's not a murderer. Yet.
Hi, Polly.
Morning, sir.
Thanks for that. With a bit of luck, you won't have to put it back up.
Sir, there's another one down the corridor. Do you want me to take that down as well?
Yeah, do. If we get this bloke into the station, I don't want him reading about himself on every wall.
Seabrook David. Sorry, Susan, no trace.
Okay, then. Better give him a call.
He'll probably be out.
Out of the country, if he's got any sense.
You're pretty convinced it's your indecent assaulter?
Well, the victims may not have been able to describe his face very well, but they're all very clear about the knife. 7 or 8 inch blade, serrated edge, bone handle. Can't be too many of those around.
Hello, Mr. Seabrook? Yeah, this is Sunhill Police. You reported your car stolen? Yes, we have found it. Picked it up first thing this morning. I'm not sure, I'll have to check the crime sheet. If you could just bear with me for a second. Thank you. Did we get the bloke who nicked it?
The bloke who's going to have to blame the knife on. Tell him no.
Hello? No, nothing here, I'm afraid. If you could come into the front office and ask for a WDC Susie Croft, she'll be able to sort you out. Right you are. Okay, thank you. Be here in 20 minutes.
As long as he doesn't have to stop and ask a woman directions.
Wipe clean, I'd say.
Makes sense. He's been pretty careful so far.
Is this the bloke who's been following women off buses?
Yeah. Seems to be his preferred method. He looks harmless, comes up, asks them for directions, and then bang, they get that thing stuck in their face.
You want me to work on the boot of the car?
Yeah, but not until he's left the station. I want to keep him guessing in the interview room.
It's a nasty surprise for the poor man.
I hope so.
I'll make a start on the inside.
CID. Thanks, Polly. He's downstairs. Confident and very, very punctual.
I was hoping for the day off, actually. But I suppose once this lot has been sorted out, I'd better make an appearance. Hey, this is definitely my area manager.
Mr. Seabrook.
Oh, good morning. Susie.
Susie Croft. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for finding my car. Thank you. 469.
Is it badly damaged?
I've seen worse.
Drivable.
About as far as the nearest garage.
All happens here, eh?
So what do you do?
For a living, I sell space in trade directories. Advertising space. Need a plumber, call such and such. I actually go in, meet these guys, talk through what they want, help design their ads. It's all right.
Morning.
This is D.I. Deakin, Mr. Seabrook.
Morning.
How'd you do?
I was expecting it to be all smashed up or something.
I think you got off lightly.
What is it, just a window? Oh, and the ignition and the stereo. Oh, well, never mind. Not my problem. Company car.
Would you mind just checking to see if anything else is missing?
Sunglasses still there, tie, petrol receipts, tapes. No. Looks like all my rubbish is still there.
Right. Well, we're going to need your fingerprints for elimination purposes.
Yeah, okay. Clever business, eh?
They always leave something. A bit of skin, fibres off the clothing, that sort of thing.
The thief went in the boot as well.
Oh, he wouldn't have found much in there.
Spare tyre?
Yeah, well, apart from that. Did he get it? No. Didn't get anything at all, did he?
He ran off as soon as he saw the patrol approaching.
Think you'll catch up with him?
Well, if we can take your fingerprints now, we can get started.
Fine by me.
Plumbing DC Croft will show you where to go.
Off to you.
No, it's not a bad job. I mean, it gets a bit full on when I'm trying to make Target, you know. I'm trying to increase the size of their ads. They're cutting their workforce. Still, gets me out of the bag.
Last one.
Pity. I was enjoying that.
Yeah, well, maybe you wouldn't if we already had them on record.
Mine? Nah. Oh, Glossman did the bullion job.
There you go. Oh, come this way. Comes off pretty easily if you use that stuff.
Tea or coffee? Well, you've got to take a loser statement and ask you a couple of questions, so we may as well make you comfy.
Oh, coffee then, please. Milk, two sugars.
OK.
He's our man.
Got a confession.
All right, then. Innocent until proven lying.
Make the bail inquiries on Reynolds, Sarge.
Yeah, in a minute. The other one's still here.
All done?
Yeah, just about.
Come off all right?
Mm-hmm.
OK, come with me, then.
You wouldn't think it to look at him, would you?
He's got a smile and a knife. What more do you need?
So, apart from the obvious damage to your car, none of your personal belongings appear to be missing?
No, I don't think so. Mind if I smoke?
I'd prefer it if you didn't, actually. Well, if you really want one.
No, fair enough. No problem.
Can I show you something?
Depends what it is. Sales rep humour.
Never seen that before?
Nope.
Maybe if I give you a closer look. So you can see, the handle's quite distinctive and the blade has a serrated edge.
No, never seen it.
Now, we believe that this knife has been used by a man who's committed several indecent assaults on women in the Sun Hill area.
A man who targets women on buses in the evenings, follows them when they get off, and then distracts them by asking directions.
It was found in your car.
Well, it's not mine.
No?
Oh, come on, you know it's not.
All we know is that it was found in your car.
Well, it must belong to the thief then, mustn't it? He must have dropped it when he ran off. I mean, he's a bloke you should be asking.
We have asked him.
I thought you said you hadn't caught up with him.
No. We said he'd run off. An officer chased him and arrested him.
Well, I'm sorry, I'm just going to have that cigarette now. Sorry. I had my car nicked, and you lot found it, which was great. But you also found this thing, which you think's been used by some bloke who rapes women, yeah?
He hasn't raped, yeah.
No. He simply holds the knife to their throat while he indecently assaults them.
Yeah, well, right, whatever.
Can you offer any other explanation why the knife might have been in the back of your car?
Well, I don't know, maybe a mechanic left it there or someone at work having a laugh.
Is that sales rep humour again?
Well, you know what I mean. Don't twist my words.
You don't ever take the bus, do you?
No. Well, yeah, sometimes. That was a closed question. They teach us that in sales. How to steer people into giving the right answers. Open questions, closed questions.
5 women have been attacked in 6 weeks. We want the man responsible.
I expect you do, but don't start accusing me, because that thing's not mine. What about fingerprints? You must have checked it for them.
It's been subject to a lot of tests. We have to wait for the results.
Well, when you get them back, I can tell you for a fact, they'll show I've never touched it, because it's not mine.
All right. We'll take a break there. I'm arresting you on suspicion of indecent assault.
Me? Why?
You do not have to say anything.
I haven't said anything.
But it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questioned something you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence, OK? Well, we'll book you in and then we'll cough to...
27A Golding's Crescent.
What? You're going to search my flat?
That's the next step, yep.
Why don't you put the cigarette out, eh?
Yeah.
You've had breakfast, you made bail, what more do you want?
I suppose I should get a bit of credit for helping you find the knife.
Credit?
Yeah, you know, we're with the magistrate.
Oh, shut up.
Well, I still think you should be grateful.
On behalf of everybody at Sun Hill, who's ever called you nicking a car, thank you.
Yeah. Look for everything, don't you?
Have to.
Aftershave I got off my folks at Christmas. Tweezers for my nasal hair. Toothbrush. Toothpaste. Shaving foam. Oh. Soap I nicked out of a hotel you might want to question me about as well.
No?
Gonna let that one go, are you?
Nothing in the bathroom, bud.
All right. Can I get you a book or something?
I'm fine just watching you, thanks.
So what's in these, then?
Very nice. Expensive, too.
Nah, I didn't pay for any of it. Went out in a transit the other night, did a ram raid. Look, you can turn this place inside out. You won't find anything.
Had a quick clear out, did you?
No. There's nothing to find. What are you looking for? A set of six matching sheath knives? You're doing my head in.
This is how you spend your evenings, then? No girlfriend at the moment?
No. You? I'll stick your number down on the pad. I'll give you a call. Family. What?
Your hair's longer in this one.
Fashions change. Still got a baseball cap, though.
Mr. Seabrook. I found this, down by the side of the bin.
Found what?
Well, I'm not very good at jigsaw puzzles, but it does look to me like a London Transport bus pass.
So?
Is it yours?
Would you think it'll have your fingerprints on it?
Well, it might be mine, yeah, but what does that prove?
I thought you said you didn't use the buses.
No, I said I do sometimes.
Enough to justify buying a bus pass.
Right, that's it. Before you lock me up on the strength of an old bus pass, I think I want to see a solicitor.
He let us have his fingerprints because he knew they were useless. He let us search his flat because he knew we wouldn't find anything.
We found the bus pass. That shook him up enough to get a solicitor.
The only thing he's ventured voluntarily is that he's still got this baseball cap in his wardrobe.
So?
There's a bell ringing somewhere.
Ring it louder, I'm not hearing anything.
I think the reason he's being so careful isn't because he doesn't want to make a mistake. It's because he doesn't want to make another one. Indecent assault, Laswade Lane.
Go back a bit to the 14th.
May the 11th.
It's a very different MO.
Yeah, I know, Gov. We had this down as a one-off. I think it was the kickoff.
It's your brief.
Thank you.
Fiona Parks.
Hello. Dave Seabrook.
Hello. Thank you. I reckon Seabrook knew he had a choice. He could either stop, consider himself lucky that he got away with Laswade Lane, or he could carry on.
Difficult to stop doing something you enjoy.
Yep. But he did stop, didn't he? That's why he's so dangerous. He got himself a haircut, changed his appearance, and has spent the last 8 months working out a brand new MO for himself. He got a knife, gloves, disposable clothing, the lot, and he's put us right off the track.
You're digging back a bit, aren't you?
Coincidence? I don't think so.
Neither do I. Let's go back to last Friday.
Oh, I've told you.
We seem to be travelling in circles. That's the third time you've asked that question, Inspector.
I'm aware of that. But each time I phrased it differently, and I'm still not happy with the answer.
I'll bet the bloke who nicked my car didn't get this kind of hard time.
It's not exactly a crime of the same magnitude, is it? Susie.
I'm showing Mr. Seabrook Exhibit SC4. It's a photograph removed during the search of his flat. It's a family snapshot in which Mr. Seabrook is standing with an older woman. They're both smiling for the camera. Would you say that's a fair description?
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose.
And the woman?
That's my mother.
Can you tell us when it was taken? Well, I expect your mum will remember the date.
Probably around March time.
March.
Yeah, just don't go bothering my folks with questions, all right?
Well, we won't need to if you answer them for us. Your hair was longer then?
Well, yeah. Obviously.
Why did you have it cut?
I don't know. I got fed up with it, I suppose. Just fancied a change.
Can you tell us when you had it cut?
Well, it's probably just after that. Yeah, March or April.
Well, which one? March or April?
Probably April.
Probably.
Well, I don't know. I don't remember. It was a while ago.
I don't think you had it cut until the middle of May.
You might be right, but unfortunately, I just don't remember.
But you do remember where you had it cut?
Well, it was down towards Bromley. I've been meaning to get it cut for a while, and I was driving past this place, I saw it, I thought, yeah, that'll do. I didn't make an appointment.
So we can't check. What car were you driving at the time?
What car? Well, basically the same ones I got out there.
Yeah, but that one's new, isn't it?
Yeah, well, same model, though. Company car.
Same colour?
No.
What colour?
Well, the one I drove most of the time was white.
Is this relevant to anything?
I think so.
Yeah? Well, like what?
I'm now showing Mr. Seabrook Exhibit AW1, a baseball cap. And this is a crime sheet, dated May 11th last year. It concerns an attack on a woman in Laswade Lane.
That's not mine. Now, she's twisting things. You know it's not mine. You've seen mine in my wardrobe.
The man, who she thought was in his early 30s with long brown hair, came upon her quickly from behind. He punched her twice hard in the face, put his hand over her mouth and dragged her by her hair into the garden of a derelict house. There, he pushed her face into the dirt and proceeded to subject her to a serious sexual assault.
This has absolutely nothing to do with me.
Despite the fact that this was a vicious and violent assault, the woman fought back. She held on to her attacker even though he punched and kicked her repeatedly. She wasn't able to stop him running away, but she was able to grab this baseball cap from his head.
It's not mine.
Her screams were heard by a man working on a nearby allotment. He didn't actually see her attacker, but he did see a white car, possibly an Astra, pulling away from the old Seacoal Street at very high speed.
My baseball cap's at home. There are a lot of white Astras about. It wasn't me. I wasn't there. I don't attack women.
This is your baseball cap, isn't it, David?
No, you know it's not. She's seen it in my wardrobe.
No, I've seen one like it in your wardrobe.
Oh, what did I do? Lose that one and go out and buy another?
Yes, I think that's exactly what you did.
No, this is crazy. Look, I've been completely cooperative. I've answered all their ridiculous questions as best I can. I don't see what else I can do.
Do you really want to prove it's not yours?
You'll want to know what shop I bought it in. Whether I've still got the receipt from 2 years ago. What number bus stops outside?
No. We can prove it.
Really?
There was some hair on this. Some of the attacker's hair. Hair that was subjected to DNA profiling. Do you know what that is, David?
Yeah, I've heard of DNA. You can make dinosaurs from it. Build your own park.
DNA is a minute amount of genetic material that can be extracted from human tissue. Blood, saliva, skin.
Hair?
Just like we all have unique fingerprints, we all have unique DNA. The only people who have the same DNA are identical or coplacental twins. Do you have an identical or coplacental twin, David?
Yeah. But I haven't seen it for years.
You give us a sample of your hair and we can compare it against the sample taken from this that's stored on our database. If it doesn't match, and you're certain that it won't, then that's it. You're out of the frame.
I shouldn't be in the frame.
I can't twist a DNA sample, David. 10 hairs from your head, including roots, that's all it would take to clear your name once and for all. It's as simple as that.
Is it?
So what do you say?
I don't know.
Well, the fact is, we don't need your consent.
Well, don't bother asking me if you're just going to do it anyway.
For a non-intimate sample, which is what head hair is, I can get authorization from the chief superintendent.
Well, you better do that, then.
Is this the first time we've had a refusal?
For a non-intimate sample, yes.
Which rather suggests he's worried that his sample will match the entry on the DNA database.
I don't think it's a civil liberties issue, sir.
I will see if they'll listen to reason first. Matthew? Afternoon, Fiona.
Hello.
Well, we'll give it one last try, shall we? Mr. Seabrook? Chief Superintendent Brownlow.
Pleased to meet you.
I understand that you've been asked to provide a sample of your head hair for DNA analysis and that you've refused.
I don't see why I should end up on some database when I haven't done anything wrong.
You're under suspicion of having committed a serious offence.
It's only suspicion.
And I have reasonable grounds to believe that the taking of the sample would tend either to confirm or disprove your involvement. I'm sure that your solicitors explained that to you.
I thought she was here to defend me. Instead, she's on your side, isn't she?
It's not a question of sides. It's the law.
See? All she does is stand there checking her nail varnish.
We will take a sample, Mr. Seabrook.
Can I have another word with my client, please?
No. And what the hell for? You're useless. The best thing you can do, love, is clear off. Go back to drawing up wills or whatever you normally do.
Mr. Seabrook?
I mean it. Just clear off.
Are you dismissing your solicitor?
Yeah. Yeah, I am. Oh, thanks very much, Fiona. You've been a great support. Bye. And why don't you go with her and all?
Mr. Seabrook, would you like us to contact another solicitor who can act on your behalf?
Yeah, right. Hey, next time you get me one with a moustache, make sure it's a bloke.
Yes or no?
No.
And are you prepared to let one of the officers take a sample of your hair for DNA analysis?
That's no as well. I don't see why I should.
Then I'm authorising it to be taken without your consent.
Shall I round up some troops, sir?
Oh, it's all right, Chris. I'll just enter the authorisation in the custody record and see what I can find. Are you too busy?
We just finished writing up our notes, sir.
Well, we've got a suspect in the cells who won't consent to a DNA sample. I'd like you on hand in case there's a problem.
It's a saliva sample, is it, sir?
No, head hair. Can you come through and see Sergeant Gordon? Mr. Seabrook, have you reconsidered your refusal? It really would be best, you know, for you and everybody if you just accepted the inevitable. I shall take that as a refusal. All right.
There is an easy and a hard way of doing this. Just sit up, please. Hold your arms away from your sides. Mike, Dave. Okay, Susie.
Bov. I need to pluck the hairs to get to the roots. Do it as quick as I can, okay?
Mr. Seabrook. Just sit still.
Right, get out! Get him down! Arm out! Right, cuffs!
Keep still and shut it.
Do it, Susie.
Get off me.
Keep still.
That'd be the only time you'll ever get a bloke. When he's held down.
Shut it!
Go on. Put him a bit harder if it gives you a thrill. Go on. Couldn't do it on your own now, could you? Eh? Try doing this without a load of blokes to help you out. I know how far you'd get. No, you wouldn't like that at all, would you? Out on your own. Just me and you. Hey? Hey?
Done.
10.
10.
You think you got me? Hey? You really think you've got me?
Is that a closed question?
You want me to wipe that smile off your face, huh? Because I can, you know. I know how to. And I wouldn't need a knife. No, a knife's only an accessory.
Well done, Susie.
Yes.
You have been so clever there.
All of you.
Thanks for your help, guys.
You know, my time. I can pick and choose. Yeah, go on.
All alone. Just me and you.
Candlelit assault for two.
You want me to tell you what it's like, do you?
It's going out in a blaze of glory. Shame you haven't got that on tape.
Give him time. We will.